Now, just 3 sips of water. One. Two. Three.
It's not every day one gets to bask in the glory
of an angel.
Angel? As angel, to be exact. That's who I am. Sent from above. Impending perfection.
What do you want?
Right to the chase. The truth is, honey, you're one of a kind. And to put it bluntly, what I want is your face removed, your skin peeled away like paper, and your insides torn out and tossed onto my table. Custom parts, ready for my delicious harvest. And with your generous sacrifice, I'll But for now, let's have fun. Plenty of time for a bloodbath later. Ooh, how about a game? Let's all play a game of riddles.
Riddles? What a wonderful idea!
No. All right, honey. Here's the deal. Behind you is the door to freedom. But it will only be opened if you solve my little puzzle and return to your special chair. Then, I'll throw this heavenly switch here. If you get the puzzle right, you walk away. Get it wrong, you fry.
Let's begin.
The fox thinks the rabbit smells of elderberry. I couldn't see them sitting together.
The bird won't have anything to do with the rabbit, but I hear he likes to court danger by sitting next to the fox.
The rabbit never sits with the bird, but he loves to play the company of the bear.
The fox has always hated the bear. They never sit next to each other.
The pompous fox? He wouldn't be caught dead if he left. Far too pedestrian.
My friend the bear always sits next to the bird. After all, they went to school together. My friend the bear always sits next to the bird.
Thank you.
Hold on tight, honey. Here it comes. 3, 2, 1.
Where did you go?
Ow!
Always were. My Why does this feel so familiar? Are you all right, Audrey?
Alice, I cannot begin to tell you how good it is to see you. And this must be your wolf.
Audrey, meet Tom. He's my protector. My friend.
You both got here just in time. Now I understand why you don't like being called Alice.
The machine creates many of the same forms. At least, on the outside. On the inside, we're all pretty different.
Well, from now on, I'm gonna call you something other than Alice. It just doesn't suit you.
Oh? What do you have in mind?
How about... Allison?
It's not bad. Okay, I'll try it out. But only if you can tell me what in heaven's name you're doing in Wilson's retreat.
Wilson, I almost forgot. I have to get back right away.
Are you crazy? Wilson's our enemy.
Do you even know him? Have you ever talked to him?
I've seen what he's done. That's good enough for me.
Look, it sounds like he has a plan to kill the ink demon. For good. And I think he can help us all. I just need to go back and hear him out.
Well, if it's true, you'll both need as much help as you can get. The ink demon won't go down without a fight. Tom and I will gather some of our friends. Anyone who's left. Good luck, Audrey.
You too, Allison.
Mind if I take this?
Thank you for coming all this way. The ink demon is a formidable foe. To truly destroy such a monster, he must be dethroned, humiliated. For months now, I've been working on something that will do exactly that. Cast out the demon, and put a new deity in his place. Stronger, more powerful, and controllable. Together, we just need to unleash our ultimate weapon. Come, let me show you my creation. Isn't he beautiful? Simple, but elegant. A treasure. Powerful beyond anyone. The ink demon will fall, and we can have peace at last.
It could work, but... it sounds risky. How will we control him? We don't want to repeat Joey's mistake.
No, we don't. All of the factors must be perfect. The right design, the right science, and the right soul.
What?
At last your purpose is revealed, Audrey. This is why you're here. With your soul inside him, my creation will live forever.
Stay away from me. You're insane.
Come now, Audrey. Part of you knew this was your path. Leave yourself behind and ascend.
I thought you said we needed to save your father. I thought you had a plan to send me home, to make everything right.
I lied. My father is beyond hope. Perhaps you know him. Nathan Arch, owner of Archgate, industrial genius, business tycoon. For years, I've lived in his reaching shadow. He always had time for the grand creatives of the world, the doers, as he called them. He knew only the best, the biggest thinkers. How could his lonely son ever hope to compete with that? But now, thanks to you, I can. No need to struggle. My signal prevents you from using those devilish powers of yours. And more importantly, keeps the ink demon from getting in. It's time to die, Audrey. And live again as a god.
No, not this time.
Thank you. there's always a choice. I know you're in there. Deep behind that evil face. Inside somewhere is my little girl. My Audrey. My greatest creation.
I'm scared. I don't know what's happening.
The past doesn't define you, nor the present. In the end, all those years ago, Joey Drew finally succeeded. He created life. But Audrey, you're so much more than that. You were his family. His daughter. My daughter. And I love you so very much.
Be quiet. The bridge is near.
Remember who you are, Audrey. Remember.
Human words are waste. The failure of Joey Drew dies here.
I know you're in there. You don't have to be this anymore. It's never too late. Just a pencil and a dream. Is that enough? You have to have heart.
No!
The future is sealed. What do you think you're doing?
I'm starting over. This is the end.
Thank you. the ink demon rises! Surrender yourself to the Lord of the Dark Tunnels! It's time to believe!
Some help?
Henry, you came!
Some battles are worth fighting for, even a million times. Come on, I found a projector up ahead. Run for it.
This man is mad, and the cycle will come to you.
Well then, we'll just have to do better next time. My father once told me that just because we're born of darkness doesn't mean we belong to it. We're always free to choose. And here, at the very beginning, there's a choice to make. My father's cartoon world was now mine, to rule, to watch over, and to protect. I can make the cycle more bearable for my friends inside. But as for me, I'm the first of my kind. Born of ink, but living in flesh. Joey's world is escaping into ours. So, what's next? Who can really say?